Now that the base is connected to the leg, I'd like to work on the connection between the leg and this top housing. And a quick way of cleaning up our viewport, I really want to hide everything except for these two components. So I'm just going to shift click those two, or control click those two, either one, right click, and go down to isolate. That will hide everything except those two, and it'll give me a little floating window here with an exit isolate button. And I'm just going to put it up here so I can get to it. And whenever we need to bring back all of the other stuff in our assembly, we just click exit isolate and everything comes back. So it's a very convenient, quick way of hiding everything except the stuff we're currently working on. Now, this top housing, this blue top housing, I've decided is going to be a giant injection molded piece. It's going to be expensive, but it's going to be functional. It's going to be injection molded out of probably something like glass-filled nylon, or GFN, a really stiff material that gives us a lot of the properties that we want without a lot of the manufacturing limitations that come along with sheet metal. And then this bottom piece, once again, we're going to cast that and then machine it. So we have all kinds of flexibility. It's going to be incredibly expensive to make, but it's going to be awesome. So let's edit this part in context. I'm going to edit that leg in context here. And before we do anything, I want to get rid of these minor fillets because those were really just cosmetic anyway. I'm going to delete that fillet and also delete this minor fillet. So we're left with no fillets. We can add those in again later if we want to. Next, we'll go up to our, let's find our surfaces tab. And then I'm gonna have to extend mine down to show all of the surfaces tools and do an offset surface. I'll choose this top face. We're gonna offset by 0, effectively just duplicating that face. And then head also in the surfacing tab over to the thicken command. I can thicken that surface offset. I'm going to thicken it by 3 millimeters upward, and I am not going to merge result. What we're doing now is kind of a hack. It's really a shortcut, but it works really nicely. Now I have a separate body here to work with, so I can go to my direct editing tab, move face. I want to be in offset mode, and I'm going to move this exterior face on this side, and also this exterior face on the other side. And I can move those by however much I want, let's say 12 millimeters, so I've got plenty of purchase to work with, and hit OK. And now I've got a little flange that can hold our GFN housing in place, right? I can also go up to, let's do that again. Let's do move face, and I'll select this front face and the back face. And these guys, we want to actually go the opposite direction. I'm going to flip that direction. We'll go 12 millimeters inward and hit OK. The reason for that is because we need space for the front and rear nose cones to be able to extend inward into this as well, so that those have plenty of support. You'll see what I mean later. All right, so this is getting closer to what we want it to be. And with that, let's exit isolate to bring back all the other stuff in our assembly. We now have a nice flange, a nice mating feature on this part, and we're going to need a way of connecting, say, this back piece to the rest of our housing. And we need to do that in draft so that this back piece can just slide straight in. You can imagine that if we just created a flange that goes in here, it would be out of draft. You wouldn't be able to insert this part in any way. It would be impossible. So we need to create a drafted feature for that. So to do that, let's select these three parts again and right-click and isolate those three this time. So we're just looking at the stuff that we need. I'm going to edit this part in context for the moment. And first of all, we are also, once again, let's delete these minor radii. So I'll select this and that, hit delete, so we're getting both of those features out of here. And we can add them back in again later. So let's actually work on a way of connecting this back piece to the main body.